Welcome back to the living room. I'm Jacob with Power Fitness, and today is just going to be a feel-good workout. Just getting that feel-good flowing, using the TRX and the Kettle Bell. Right now I'm listening to Grandmaster Flash. Grandmaster Flash, turntables, old school mix. So, you want to check it out. I left the people that uploaded it and stuff in the description below, so you can punch that into your search and check it out.
Watch out, puppy. Watch out.
All right. So first, I'm just going to start off with a little warm up. I'm going to do some front lunges, lifting my arms up, and then also lifting my arms out to the sides. I'm not even counting, so I don't know how many reps that was. That video stopped, and because it may contain music, audio, video that belongs to someone else, creative broadcast. Okay. Let me find something else to listen to, shall I? Because apparently, they're gonna throw a big fuss about this. I mean, it's uploaded to YouTube by someone else. So, I mean, really? So, I'm just gonna go to Radio Cutman. Alright? Radio Cutman, lo-fi beats and video game music by DJ Cutman. So, I'm gonna go ahead and do that one. Alright, and welcome back again. They cut off the music because apparently listening to Grandmaster Flash on YouTube with it uploaded by someone else is fucking against some kind of copyright things, whatever. It makes no sense to me at all, but whatever, here we go. So, DJ Cutman. Let's keep moving. I was doing some butterflies and some front raises here. I'm gonna go ahead and do one more.
It's each way. Nah, let's go two more. Listening to that won't get you booted for copyright stuff, even though it's well, whatever. I don't pretend to understand all these copyright rules and laws and everything, so you know, if one of my videos or something I'm doing gets snagged or nicked for something like that, I'm not doing it on purpose. So if you don't want your music being available for other people to listen to, quit making it. You know? Be free with the music, dude. I mean, yeah, live your life making monies and stuff, but once it's out there, let it be out there. Quit being a douche. I mean, you can still sell tickets to all your concerts and everything. Damn. Just like with all my little, workout video log that I got going on. You know, that's where the farm of fitness is. Once it's out there, it's out there. Free for everyone to use. Because physical fitness is something that should be available to everyone. You know? Yeah, you're gonna need some coaching and stuff. Sometimes you're gonna have to pay for that, especially if you want it individualized. So, you just do what you can within the means that you got. And speaking of that, sometimes within the means of a big chunk of the population is the programs, workouts, and then nutritional counseling at Damn Serenity Athletics. You know? Great stuff. Lots of really great workouts. About this TRX is that when using it for a lot of your lower body movements, it takes a lot of that strength off your knee, it takes a lot of that load off. So that way I'm able to get in there and get it moving without a lot of unnecessary discomfort. Sip of water. Felt good. Felt real good. Kettlebell right there. Grab a ball. Grab this one here kettlebell. Alright.
Having to sit down.
You're gonna bring us up to that little wrap position. Sitting on our the cup right here is a little nest. You get your chest, I mean your fist up here to your chest. Alright? And it creates this little nest right here that the kettlebell sits in. Boom. It's home. It's happy. Alright? Go roll these out right here. Between my shoulder blades. Go press this up to start position. Alright, this kettlebell is kind of cool, right? As opposed to a dumbbell, where you have the weight directly on top, stacked above your bones, right? This one has the weight off to one side, right? So now you're gonna have to hold your arm more stable. It takes a little bit more to stabilize it. I mean, so, whatever. Do what you do, push it. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Other side. Again, keep it nice and stable. Also, while doing all this, keep your glutes engaged and your hips locked, nice and flat, okay? Stay tight through your core, so that way it doesn't try to roll you off one side. A good wide base with your feet also helps. What is that, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Always bring it down to your chest before you switch. Don't do it over in the air, because if it slips and falls, it's gonna hurt you. Reach your back, keep that elbow pointed up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, one more, come on. 8, oh, woo. 5, 6, come on, 7, and one more time, 8, goodness gravy, back to pushing, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, whew, it's burning, 10, ah, come on. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, oh, come on, 9, 10, it's on fire, shoulder and I rolled out of socket. Don't worry. I'm fine. It's an old injury. Iron way back. You know, tore out like both my rotator cuffs. Bad. And so now I'm not really careful about the motions that I do. My shoulder just rolls right out of socket. You know, so I let that elbow face out just a little bit, boop, which what created a little bit of structural weakness there, right? Because now my tricep there and my lats are really working together to pull it in and over, and it just rolled out of socket. So hopefully you haven't earned that that little problem yourself. I say earned it because, I was pushing hard when it happened. I'll tell you about it. Here's my junior year high school football offseason. Yeah, that long ago. And I was doing military press. Now, doing an overhead shoulder press behind the neck. As people such as Jeff Cutler has said multiple times, that behind the neck shoulder press really puts your shoulders at a mechanical disadvantage and also opens it up to injury, because now it's... He can explain it much better than I can. Anyways, here's how it happened. It was that trying to push that last rep of that last set, doing 3 sets of 10, right? Pushing it up, and it just went back. Just went back. This hand let go after my arm went 90 degrees backwards. You see how far it goes here? Now, magnify that, like, wah, way back. My left hand held the bar all the way around, all the way back. All I heard in both my ears was this intense ripping, snapping, popping sound. I fell out of the seat, clutching my shoulders. They hurt so bad. Oh my God, they hurt so bad. You know, no, I didn't go see any doctors for it because the coach was just like, just keep it moving. You just stranded, whatever. So the next day, couldn't even lift my arms. It was agonizing pain to try to put on a shirt. And then, again, being poor and everything, I couldn't go and see anyone about my shoulders to get them fixed. So I had to rehab them myself by doing my own research. And also, I really love the human body, anatomy, biology, all that. So I was really keen into reading up on all of that stuff. And so, anyway, that's how I hurt my shoulder. This floor is wet, slippery from my sweat, so I'm gonna put down a mat. Cause I gotta do some kettlebell swings now. Floor. So anyways, you gotta be careful. You gotta be careful. Even at a young age, man. You injure yourself, you get hurt, it sticks with you for life. You know? That's not bad. The only injury I suffered when I was younger, I also got kicked in the spine between my shoulder blades. That happened once. And from that day forth, my back has never been the same. You know, I get, even to this day, you know, three of the vertebrae right here between my shoulder blades and the thoracic area are kind of smashed together and slightly twisted, you know, so they're not quite in line with everything else. So, that's another reason why I got to keep working out. Because if I let my muscles atrophy, my shoulders fall out of socket. My back will start to twist up again because it's all the muscles holding it and pulling it, what keeps it where it's supposed to be. And if I let those atrophy and get weak, my back will twist up. My shoulders will fall out of socket. My hips will come out of socket. My knee, forget about it. You know, so gotta keep moving. You got to, all right? It's vital. It really is, okay? All right, now I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna go into some kettlebell swing, all right? I see lots of different variations of it. I like the variation that don't hurt my back or my knees, okay? And that's where I get more flex in my knees and keep my back a little more upright. Where I'm coming down here, it's kind of like a half squat almost, is the position I'm getting here. So I'm loading up my glutes and my hamstrings, right? And protecting my back to where it's the motion of this, almost from a jump, from a half squat down to a jump, all right? This hip thrust screen forward, boom! And that is what propels my weight up to the sky because my arm is just resting against my thighs, all right? And if my arm's resting against my thighs, my hips, boom, explode forward, and they throw my arms up. And that's what generates the lift on my kettlebell swing. I see others out there where they keep more of a semi-stiff legged position, right? And they do mostly this, kind of like almost like a ballistic Romanian deadlift. I'm not a fan of that, again, because back issues. A fast downward motion and then a quick change with just a little bit too much fatigue going on right here in your glutes, say you relax them, just a slight amount, trying to come back up, you gotta slip a disc. That's why I like to keep mine more vertical, okay? Choose the one that works for you. I'm doing one that I like, all right? So, I'm gonna start off with both hands. I'm gonna start facing you, here we go. To come down, boop, and to pop my hips. What's that, 10? So that's 45. Again, just, you know, keep steady pace, steady breathing, and you can just sail along, and you don't really notice how out of breath you are until you stop. I don't know if any of y'all experienced that. Where you're going, and you're not realizing how much you're putting forth as far as effort until you gotta stop. And then your heart's going and it's difficult to keep your breath back up. So that's why you see me a lot of times walk around. It's because I'm having trouble getting my air and equalizing my breathing and my heart rate. That didn't make sense what I said, did I? I don't know. I have no study behind this, through nothing, but it's my own personal observation. My own observation is that there's a happy ratio of my respiratory rate and my heart rate. And when it gets out of kilter, it's a lot harder for me to get my breath. By that, I mean, you know, I'm not feeling lightheaded, you know? So, again, the walking around, the moving is to help to slowly bring your heart rate down and help you catch breath. Because if I stop moving and my heart's still going fast, it feels like I'm gonna die. Yeah, I have to keep moving, you know? So. All right. Now, that was a nice little long-winded break. I'm gonna transition into one-handed, where I'm alternating, coming down. I'm gonna change up my hands when it's up here. Because right up here, it's weightless. At the very peak of a swing, it's weightless. So you just change your hands. And you know, when you get in the zone and you're just flowing with it, you almost get that matrix feeling where it's like time stands still and you're just like, do, steps. But you're not leaning back like that because that would be stupid. No. Let's get going. Here we go. All right. Standing up here on the center and get that little squat down. All right. It may help if you get a little squat down and then swing back and pop your hips. That was 26. Let's get the heart pumping. Still got a little chest congestion going on, so that don't help. Alright. My third kettlebell swing, I'm going to be swinging to the outside. Alright. I'm going to be going in a narrower stance, and then I'm swinging down as it comes up instead of coming to center. Okay? Right, which would bring the down path past my knee. Bad idea, right? I'm gonna come up, out, at about an angle. So as I'm coming down, it's gonna travel in a path that will not collide with my knee. If I do it right. All right, I'm gonna do it one side, and get it the other side. That's hard. It's really wanting to pull you off to that one side. So you really gotta resist it. The other side. Goodness.
do to film it today. Had a bit of fun break loose, and now it's dressed. What was I was doing? Oh, they did the presses, I gotta do the rows. Alright. We'll get back on track. Now I'm gonna go into a self-supported row, okay? I'm gonna go ahead and do some mat variation, and then I'm gonna do some just bend over, all right, to get more core stability work going on. So first, I like to start standing. It's between my legs. I pivot on this heel and this toe, right? So we're now, as I bend down, push my hips back, support myself on my thigh, shoulders nice and square, back's nice and flat. Here I go, I'm gonna go ahead and pull it in. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Other side. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10. Now, I like this variation because when I have them available to me, I can grab some pretty heavy dumbbells. For me anyway, I'm talking like the 80s, you know, I'm not a mass monster. So I can grab the 80s and I'm rowing it here as I'm supporting my entire load on my frame, on my body. I'm down here in this position. Now, you sports guys out there will see, it looks almost similar, doesn't it? Looks kind of similar. Got this hand up. Where you at now? You're in a three-point stance. You ready to rock and roll? All right? You got your lead leg just a little bit in front of your rear leg. All right? Three-point stance. It's great. Especially because, see, I was a tackle, offense and defense, you know, so it depended what gap I was lining up in. You know, on defense, sometimes I'd be in the zero gap. Right there, you got the center, you got the guard. And, you know, sometimes they had that pulling guard, right? So the center would try to come down on me as that guard turns out that way. Well, what happened is I would just take off here, dump their shoulder dip behind, and you're right there in the back pocket. You're right in the back pocket, that pulling guard. Because he's going to make a hole for the running back right there, which just got the ball. Boom! You're right there, you're in. Okay? I wasn't very fast, but I got up the works enough to where the fast guys could make the play. So, I wasn't the best, but I was there and then did my damn job so that way other people could make it happen. That's what team sports is about. Anyways, that was forever ago. But now, you get the relation of this self-supported one-arm row to a sports application. You know? You're gonna be have a nice strong base from here. Boom. So, anyways, here we go. Straight up bend over, unilateral. Okay? This time, feet nice and together. Just right under my hips. Okay? Swipe down on my knees. Put them hips back. I'm gonna keep both my arms right here. So like I'm pulling. This arm here will help me know
if I'm dipping or not. Okay? So I'm picking it up, pulling it in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There we go. The reason why these bent over ones are so nice, going unilateral, really loading up those hips, engaging them, glutes, okay? Have nice, good strength, structure through there. Tighten through your core. And as this weight is moving along this one side, your body's going to want to twist. So you have to work those muscles transverse to the direction of motion. That makes sense? The direction of motion here is this way. So as the weight's coming down, my body's going to turn here. All right? So you're in a standing position, you would think this side, but now it's working here to pull that in. Alright? Anyways, I'm gonna let better people describe it. I'm just gonna execute. You don't get paid to think, crap, you get paid to execute. pulls it down in the socket, seated in there by engaging my lats. Doing this one right here from this dead pullover, help my brain and this muscle connect. Because before, if I would try to do this, I'd go to pull and I'd actually lift my shoulder out of socket, right? The opposite of what you're trying to do. I know, but we're just practicing, working on it, and flexing right down there. I'll show you in a little bit. I'm not the best at flexing and posing, but it helps to get that mind-muscle connection. But doing this, right, helped me get it in there on how to lock in my lats while doing a bench press, all right? Allowing my pectorals to do work, my shoulders, just to stabilize the load on my lats to keep my shoulders where they're supposed to be. See, it starts to get fatigued, and then I relax on it, and it doesn't come up. Instead, I'm trying to pull my shoulder out. And there we go. So, doing that motion right there, some pullovers, really helped me to get the idea of using my lats to keep my shoulders in place while doing pressing motions, you know? Because before I started engaging nose, I overcompensated a lot with the anterior delt. And when trying to push that, it pulls your shoulder forward, right? Disengaging your pectoral through a larger amount and putting way too much strain on your shoulder and causing it again to roll out of socket and just not be right. And so, but working those exercises, okay, the lighting's not the best, and yeah, I'm never gonna be under a model, but sure what I'm talking about. Flexing your lats out, boop, as you go and you do that press motion, keeps your shoulders down and back in place, and that's just what it's meant by screwing your shoulder blades into the bench. Quite literal, the motion is flexing out, boom. As you flex up, that locks your shoulders back and down, stretching out the pectoral muscle. So that way you can get the maximum amount of range and effort in that pec while keeping your shoulders in place. So, there you go. Flex your lats, do your pullovers, and flex in the mirror. I know it's really funny, and you know, not everyone's gonna have that supermodel muscle man physique. I still don't have it. I'm coming along pretty good though. I'm down to 180. To about, and that is from 273, and that's just come from daily movement. All right, keep that daily motion going, keep working out, watch what you're eating. My biggest struggle was portion control. All right, I'm gonna talk to you about that for a little bit. Portion control, you gotta think about the human body. All right, how big is your stomach really? Now, if you load up a plate with a big old amount of food like that, that's way too much, man. Your stomach is small. It's only about the size of both your fists, maybe a little smaller, okay? That's it. So, here we go. This helps for me, may differ for you. But when I would go to eat like a portion of meat, whatever, chicken, steak, something or other,
I use my hand as my measurement, okay? I don't weigh it all out. Again, a lot of people say that you should, but if you go like this, you get pretty roundabout guesstimation, fair enough, good nutrition for a fair enough, good enough body, okay? I'm happy with how my transformation is going, with how I'm looking, because I'm working out predominantly to feel good. That's it, to feel good and have less chronic pain, all right? So again, back to portion size. I look at my hand, without the fingers and without the thumb, the circumference of your hand, right there, and the thickness of your palm. That's about the size of portion of me. Just the hand portion, just the circumference of your palm and the thickness of that hand. There's your meat. Boom, okay? Now, for your carbohydrates for that meal, again, this portion of me, there's your fingers. Boom. That is your portion size of carbohydrates, okay? The thickness and the circumference of your fingers grouped together, flat. Boom. Meat, carbohydrates, right? Your rice, potatoes, whatever it is in your deal. You know, beef, chicken, fish, whatever, okay? Veggies, make a fist. Your entire fist is gonna be the size of your veggie portion. So you got your meat portion right here, carbohydrate portion, got your proteins, got your carbs, you got your veggies in there. All right, now, what about the fats, guys? Come on, there's gonna be fats in your food. If you're gonna be eating fish and stuff, there's omega fats in there. Boom, that's on it. You wanna add some like olive oil or something like that to your veggies, boom, there's some good healthy fats in there, okay? But that portion control is what really helped me out in retraining my brain to recognize when I am full, all right? Because if you keep eating these big, big meals, your stomach, it's made of muscle. What does muscle do when put under load and continue to stretch out? What happens? It gets longer, it gets bigger, okay? So now it's gonna take more food to fill your stomach, to get a stretch, stretch receptors. My brain just shut up. You get those stretch receptors firing off, letting your brain know, hey, dude, I'm full, quit trying to pack it in. So it's gonna be a challenge, it's gonna be a battle. Work that portion size, okay? Drink lots of water. Drink like 12 to 24 ounces of water with that meal, okay? Because again, whatever you put in your body that is not water, takes water to process, okay? So you gotta get plenty of water. And so say, you drank water with your meal, you ate your meal, it's only an hour and a half, 2 hours later, you're hungry again. No, you're not. You're thirsty. You are thirsty, okay? Because it took that water to process that food, but guess what? That water's still gonna be exiting and leaving your body, all right? Through the solid waste, unless you're really backed up and constipated. Ooh, that's bad, all right? And also through sweat from your workouts, which you should be doing, and also through urinating, okay? So drinking more water, because a lot of times you wake up first thing in the morning, you're feeling that hunger pains and stuff. It's really you're thirsty because you haven't been drinking. You haven't got any kind of water in your body all night. You're dehydrated, all right? Hour and a half goes by, 2 hours after a meal, you're feeling hungry again. No, you're not, you're thirsty. Drink water, okay? That's part of that portion control right there. Retraining your brain on when you're hungry and when you're thirsty and recognizing the difference between, all right? There's some pretty much guidelines for you to help you out. For more in-depth and personalized nutritional information, you want to go ahead and check out Dan Serenity Athletics. I'm talking about them a lot because it is a service that I really do believe in. It's affordable, and most importantly, it is going to be centered around you, okay? You talk to them about your nutrition, okay? That's going to be a one-on-one interview with you and Alan or Crystal, okay? I don't know which one does it. And then with the workouts. If you're a noob and you're not knowing what to do, just follow chronologically. Chris Crystal and Alan do a great job of building up on the exercises as the time continues on. So that way you're not just jumping into the middle of it going, oh my God, I'm gonna die, okay? And now for you advanced peoples out there, you're just like, I know it all, I don't need your help. Dude, I am a trainer, I don't need a personal trainer. Man, let me tell you right now, I am a personal trainer and it really does help out to get some training from the outside, because if you're just stuck inside your own head for so long, that's all you're gonna know. You're not gonna get better, you're not gonna expand, you're not gonna grow beyond yourself. Get out there and experience some other people's training, all right? Get it in you, all right? Experience that. It's only gonna make you better, okay? So by going to Damn Serenity Athletics myself and also helping to, you know, promote them, that is another toolbox in my tool shed. I don't regulate myself to one toolbox. I have multiple toolboxes, and I got a whole tool shed of cool ways to help people get fit. And I just keep on learning and keep on progressing, because again, I'm just an advanced beginner. All right, I'm always trying something new and always trying to expand my understanding. Okay, so work it yourself, and there you go. All right, thanks again for joining me. I think I've taken enough of your time. Yeah, it's been almost an hour. Check out Dance Rooney Athletics. Use the promo code Jacob to get the $2 off of your membership. Thanks again, and God bless. Ah, keep pumping. Ah, yeah. And let the feel good flow.